Welcome to the CAD Office Training Guide Series for FDOTConnect. I am Randy Roberts, CAD Application Support Specialist 4, and today I will be going through the FDOTConnect Traffic Plans Course Guide. In this series of videos, I will take you step by step through each exercise from the course guide. Today, we will start with Chapter 4 of the course guide, Traffic Planning. Topics covered in this chapter will be Traffic Planning Tool Overview, Placing RPMs, Placing Painted Pavement Messages, and Placing a Combo Painted Message and Stripe Pattern. The objective of this chapter is to provide an overview of the traffic planning tools, which contains Place Cell Group, Place Conduit, and Pay Item Update Tool. This chapter demonstrates the tools that are available within the traffic planning suite. And along the FDOT ribbon, click on Traffic Planning, opens up and has three tabs along the top: Place Cell Group, Place Conduit, and Tools and Settings. So Place Cell Group is an application within the workspace that is used to place cells along an alignment, such as painted messages, RPMs, light poles, and others. So an overview of this dialog and its applications is, for Place Cell Group, starting with the Group Pattern box, Save Pattern and Load Pattern. This function allows the designer to save a 1, 2, or 3 pattern cells. This is mainly used for painted pavement messages. The saved pattern contains the pay item data that it was created with when recalled. When recalled, the designer can place the pattern without having to browse through the database and rebuild those patterns. Cell selection with preview. The default active cell is the center. The top and bottom contain toggle buttons to make them active also. The red button allows the designer to browse the database for the desired pattern. A preview window, these three boxes here, is supplied showing the selected cell. The designer must enter in an offset distance from the selected element when the top and bottom cells are active. There is an additional control that becomes active, the upstream and downstream spacing, which controls the distance measured from the center to center of the cells between the pavement messages. In the location portion of the tool, element used for cell placement. This provides information on the source element used for cell placement. Cell placement range provides information on the source element, such as station values if element is in alignment. If it is not in alignment, the information is the begin and end coordinates. The buffer controls allow the designer to place cells at any starting or end point along the source element. For spacing and angle, the designer can control whether the cells can be placed once or incrementally along the source element. The angle control allows options of relative, absolute, and perpendicular. If you change the spacing to increment, the data box becomes active, allowing the designer to enter a spacing distance for the cells, mostly used for RPMs. Direction reverse. This will reverse the selected element's direction, which affects how the cell rotates about the source element. If you find your cell is not rotating the direction you expect, toggle this option on and the preview should change rotation of the cell in preview mode before you commit it to the design file. Associate alignment with element. When toggled, it will place all patterns associated with the selected alignment. To select an alignment, click on the green selector button to pick your alignment. The alignment name will populate in the Select text box. This is required so that your quantity reports will be accurate. You do not have to select the alignment to as your source element to place off of, you can select any line work, but you will need to have the alignment associated as you're using the tool. Switching over to the Place Conduit application, this tool is used to draw conduit between cells such as light poles. The designer selects from a list of 5 different types of conduit. The PayAtom database controls these options, and when drawn, the symbology, including the PayAtom number, is correctly placed. So if I select the PayAtom, a small version of the PayAtom database opens, and you have 5 types of conduit to choose from. And it also has an associated alignment, which you will need to select. Switching to Tools and Settings, this tool behaves like a find and replace, but only for PayAtom numbers. In the rare chance that the PayAtom number has changed or is incorrect, the designer can type in the current number and then the new value, and the number will be swapped out in the design file. So let's start with exercise 4.1, which is placing a painted pavement message. In this exercise, the designer will place a bike symbol and direction arrow in the bike lane on the south side of the roadway. So continue or open the DSGNSP01 file and zoom to station 701 as I'm showing on the screen. And open the traffic planning suite of tools. And we're going to be using place cell group. So toggle on the top cell. Notice when I do that, that becomes active and not grayed out any longer. And just to reiterate, when you are using place cell group and you're placing one cell, you do not need to toggle the top. Remember, that center one is always the default. Okay, so let's select the cell selection button, which will open up the PayAtom database. And I want to first select the through arrow. So I'm going to type in 0710111 70, hit search, and here is my through. So I'm going to select OK. Notice a preview of the arrow. And I want to go back to the database and I want to select the bike symbol. So I want to type in 0711 14160 and hit search. And then I want to use that one there. It's on the top. Select OK. And I want to, for offset, I want to change that to 2 on both. And for upstream spacing, I want to use 20. Like I said, this is measuring from the center of the bike symbol to the center of that arrow. And it would apply also for downstream spacing. We want to set the buffer distance to 50. Notice it's grayed out. We need to change the spacing and angle to increment. Notice how that activated now. So we want the buffer to be 50. We want the increment selected, and we want the spacing to be 450 feet. And we need to select our alignment. So I'm going to left click. Shows up there. And I am going to select draw pattern. So I'm going to left click there. I'm going to left click the bike lane here, the top line. Now I'm just going to move my mouse around to show you the preview. And let's say that, you know, that buffer is not what you wanted. You want it further down. or further up, you can change it here, and the preview will show you an update of that. So for that, that looks good. I'm going to left click, commit it to the file. If I zoom out, you can see that it's already placing it all the way down around the curve. Everything looks good there. So while we have this pattern, let's also go ahead on the opposite side of the road and let's place it up here. So select draw pattern, select the bike lane, and go ahead and commit that to the file. Just left click, and it's along the bike lane path on the other side. So next, we're going to go to exercise 4.2, which is placing RPMs. In this exercise, the designer will place a white-red RPM along a 1030 skip pattern that was placed in an earlier exercise. So let's continue working in the DSGN SP01 file and still using the place cell group. Go ahead and untoggle that top pattern. Notice how it grays back out, takes the preview away. And we want to browse to the white-red RPM. So instead of searching here, I'm just going to press collapse all and this expand pavement markings and pavement markers. I find that's pretty easy to navigate to. So I'm going to select the white-red, select OK. Notice the preview changes. So a couple of different changes here for the criteria. So for offset, I'm going to change that to 0 because I want that to be on top of that 1030 skip. And I still want increment, but now I want the distance to be 40 feet and I want the buffer to be 25. And with that, that would be placing the RPMs in the middle of that skip. Okay, so with all that selected, let's go ahead and turn off the construction lines. Let's get those out of the way. So I'm going to zoom in here on station 701. And I'm going to go ahead and select draw pattern. And I'm going to select the 1030 skip. I'm going to zoom out and look at the preview, make sure everything is good there. I see it is where I want it to be. So I'm going to left click to commit it to the file. Notice how much brighter it got. Whoops. And when I go around the curve, I'm just checking to see, and the RPMs rotated relative rotation around that curve, so that looks good too. Now we're going to go to exercise 4.3, which is placing a combination striping and painted pavement message. In this exercise, the designer will create and place a school pavement message. In addition to the message, this pattern requires two perpendicular pavement stripes. So go ahead and zoom to station 705, and we're going to be working on this side of the road here on the screen. And before we start, go ahead and just save your file. It's a habit of mine, so it's always good to do. All right, so continuing in the DSGN SP01 file, we're going to go ahead and close the traffic planning tool if you have it still open and open up the pavement marking tool. We're going to add the two striping patterns first, and we want stripe 2 toggled on, and we want to set the stripe 1 spacing distance to 0, and we want stripe 2 set to 24 to select a pattern that we have previously used, so it should be in your history list, which is the 710-111-25 24-inch stop line or crosswalk. We want that for both of them, so go ahead and select that. For striping method, we want to change this to draw perpendicular, and we want to set the end offset to 24.66. If your alignment's not associated, go ahead and select the alignment. And now we're ready. Go ahead and select draw pattern. For the select element, I'm going to select the bike lane and then left click down here in the travel way. And there we see our two patterns. You can go ahead and close the pavement marking tool. And let's open up the traffic planning. And we're going to use place cell group. So we want two painted messages here, school. So we're going to activate the top one. And of course, the middle one's always active by default. And we're going to select from the PayAtom database the school message. So in fact, you can just type in the name. Select search, and it pulls up the school message, and we want the same here, so we need to go back to the database. And select it. And we want the top offset to be 6, and the middle offset to be 18, and the upstream spacing to be 0, and we want to set the spacing to once. Notice these two options here grayed out, because if you're only doing it once, you'll just need to select that location in the file. We want the angle relative, and we want to select that alignment before we place this. And now we want to select draw pattern, and we'll come up here and select the kind of the halfway distance between those two stripes that we placed. So I'm going to left click here. Notice my preview. Notice there's something wrong there, right? It's rotated the wrong way. So I need to come down here and toggle on direction reverse. And now it toggles back to the correct rotation. So I'm just going to place it in the center here and just left click to commit it. And go ahead and untoggle direction reverse so it will not be on the next time you use the tool. Thank you for joining me today for Chapter 4 of the FDOTConnect for Open Roads Designer Traffic Plans Course Guide.